your machine can handle the heat, mine just survived 50 reps of synthetic layers, stacked parametric effects, and a few crunches for good measure. This is not your typical benchmark, this is a creative stress test. Introducing the ultimate free After Effects speed test file, a completely free project designed to push your system to its limits, or just let you play around with dynamic, fully editable elements that stay non-destructive and fun. Now, if you're short on time, head straight down to the description for the download link after a quick flirt with the like and subscribe buttons, of course. But if you're curious to see what's under the hood, stick around as I guide you through the file, show you how it works, and reveal the results I got on three very different machines. Because let's face it, this is a competition. Speed, power, bragging rights. Let's begin. Once you've downloaded the zip file, extract it first. On the Mac, just double click it, super easy. On Windows, don't run it from inside the zip. Drag it out to a fast SSD or NVMe drive first. You'll need After Effects 2024 or newer, and I'm slightly on a newer version, which is why I'm getting this convert to current version message. So if you do get this, just hit OK and you're good to go. Now, here is what makes this file so spicy. Everything is built from solids, shapes, text, adjustment layers, and a generous of helping effects and precomps. No external assets, nothing to import, just open and go. You'll also find 3D layers, lights, camera, and a cheeky little AE cube comp made with the Cinema 4D renderer. Yes, it's real 3D. Yes, your GPU will feel it. Now, before you hit that render button, make sure of two things. First, enable multi-frame rendering under memory and performance settings. It should be on by default, but just check it. And then purge your memory and disk cache so we are starting clean. No cheating here. Now, I'll walk you through the render setup in a second, but first, let's explore what's inside this composition. I'll scrub to the middle of the comp, or you can just type 500 in the timecode field. And then you'll need to give it a second. At full res with 16 bit per channel, After Effects is going to take a breathe here. If you're feeling brave, you can bump it up to 32 bit float, but honestly, 16 bits is plenty of stress. Now, check this out. Click the snail icon, also known as the composition profiler, and this will allow you to see how long each layer takes to render. Spoiler alert, the background layer here is the real drama queen, thanks to a radial blur effect, caustics, and the Lumetri color effect, which is, by the way, a GPU accelerated effect. Now, please feel free to poke around, steal a few setups, or just customize it for your own evil benchmarking needs. Okay, ready to test your system? Let's go to the start of this composition. Make sure nothing is selected and then choose Composition, Add to Render Queue. Under the render settings, choose best settings. Under output module, choose high quality, which uses the Apple ProRes codec. Now, save this to your fastest drive. SSD or NVMe are the best. Let's not blame slow disk speed performance for bad results. Also, a quick reminder, this comp has no audio. So if you need dramatic test music, bring your own. Now, before you render, make sure to purge memory and disk cache one more time, and then finally hit render. Don't send it to Adobe Media Encoder. We want After Effects to do the heavy lifting here. Now, pause this video and wait for the magic chime. Here it is. Then come back and drop your time in the comments below. No shame, no excuses. So if you're curious to know how did my own gear stack up, here are my results. The third place goes to my Dell workstation, armed with an NVIDIA RTX 5000. 64 gigs of RAM and 2 terabytes of storage. And this ended up at 16 minutes and 34 seconds. The second place goes to my MacBook Pro M4 Pro, which has 24 gigs of RAM and 1 terabyte of storage. And this machine scored 14 minutes and 26 seconds. And the winner takes it all is my Mac Studio M1 Ultra, which is armed with 64 gigs of RAM and 2 terabytes of SSD. And it finished this test just under 6 minutes. Yeah, that 3-year-old Mac Studio still slaps. So for me, the conclusion is very simple. No upgrade needed yet, but I'm sure your mileage will vary. So I hope this little stress test sparks your curiosity, pushes your machine safely, and maybe even teaches you something new about how After Effects behaves under pressure. If you find this tutorial useful, hit subscribe and like. More tools, tips, and motion nerdiness coming your way very soon. See you in the next render.